It means a lot of information about natural history and biology of pets in general, right? And there are many, many species of neotropical pets that are virtually unknown in terms of their biology. So it's very important to learn about the natural history of pets and to learn about the diet and the behavior, reproduction, lifestyles, cycles of pet species. It's also very important to understand about patterns of their ecology and evolution, and even for tracing strategies for their conservation. So I'll talk about the study that brings natural history information, and it's a very nice piece of work published back in 2011 that answered cool questions on the relationships of resources use and eco-morphology of Phloastomites, and revealed a lot about the natural history of a very small neotropical foliage gliding bat. So we know how the neotropical bat communities are rich, and we may expect them to present resource partitioning and different degrees of ecological specialization. So we also know about the close relationships between morphology, performance, and fitness, and the phenotype constraints a bat's performance. For example, we would expect that a small-sized bat would be constrained, perhaps, to eat on small eatings or in small items like small insects. So a small animalivorous feeding bat would therefore preferentially eat on small insects, probably, and perhaps would have a more restricted diet. But that appears to not be the case for the common big-eared bat, Micronycteris microtis. A small Phloastomite, a very small gliding animalivorous bat, weighing from 5 to 7 grams, that takes food from the substrate and that have a broader diet in ecological niches than expected, and also when compared to other fellow bats, eating from hard-bodied beetles to soft caterpillars, for example. So Charlene Santana and a team of researchers, including Inga Geupel and Elizabeth Domon, Margareta Kalko and Elizabeth Kalko, studied the feeding behavior of their model species, which was Micronycteris microtis, for this their work. And to their own works, they tested whether broad resource use is associated with specific morphological behavior and performance traits within the Phloastomite radiation. So this paper was published back in 2018 in the Open PLOS Journal, and it's called All You Can Eat: High Performance Capacity and Plasticity in the Common Big-Eared Bat, Micronycteris microtis. So the niche partition in bats has been hypothesized to be related to foraging modes or differences in characters related to the ability of processing food, for example, the bite force. So the authors filmed the bats for 80 nights in a roost. They found a roost in Panama, and these bats used this roost for interacting socially, for resting and processing food, for feeding. So the elders observe the sizes and types of prey they took, and feeding behaviors, and they characterized their bites by their observations of the movies recorded. And they also measured the bite force from other captured individuals using proper equipment for this. And in parallel, they also studied skull variation, cranial variation from museum specimens of Micronycteris microtis, and other 67 phylosomid species, and compared behavior and plasticity in the performance for them. So they then found out that Micronycters microordis ate insects from of 10 different arthropod orders from a broad spectrum of sizes, varying in length from approximately 8 to approximately 90 millimeters, and a remarkably broad diet for prey size and hardness. So this tiny bat had this really broad diet in terms of types and sizes and textures and everything. So another amazing discovery was that they report for the first time the consumption of lizard for this by this tiny little bat. And this was another big record. So this then is the smallest carnivorous bat reported with a strong bite force for its size and skull shape. So Micronycters microordis had and have has the highest bite force among all the bats they studied. Also high bite performance plasticity, and has also developed a unique sensorial strategy to the location of the prey. So all this together, the elevated performance plasticity, the high bite force, and the sensorial specialization might be crucial to this expanded niche found for this bat, and may allow it to coexist with success with other gleaning bat species in their communities.